Welcome to the, I think this is our fourth meeting of the Senate Standing Committee on Civil Service and Pensions. We are joined by a number of members of our committee. We're joined by Senator Funky, our ranking member, Senator Jackson, Senator Savino, Senator Dabo, and Senator Lanza. We have five bills on our agenda today, and our first bill is S-3378, sponsored by Senator Gennardis. The clerk will read.
An act to amend the Civil Service Law and the Administrative Code of the City of New York in relation to the rights and working conditions of emergency medical technicians employed by the New York City Fire Department.
Is there any discussion on the bill?
It's not a question. Could you explain the bill to me, please?
Sure. So, you know, the purpose of the bill is really to make sure that there are certain minimum standards and protections in place for our EMT and EMS workers. And you know, you read any of the papers, you'll see that there's been a lot of issues with how EMT and EMS workers are being treated by the city and how they, you know, whether it's their pay issues or their labor conditions or their hours they have to work. So I think this kind of just puts some minimum protections in place and allows for further discussion about how we can make sure that all of the, you know, public servants are being treated appropriately.
Is this separate and apart from issues that they that are negotiated at the bargaining table?
I mean, they certainly could be negotiated at the bargaining table, but they haven't been. And so I think the rationale behind this legislation is to say, you know, if this is not going to be done at the bargaining table through collective agreement, that we will take steps to ensure that they are getting their basic minimum protections. And so one way or the other, we want to see, you know, these issues get resolved. And so if it's not happening at one table, we should start advancing the conversation at another table.
And the reason I bring, because I notice you're amending the administrative code, you're not amending the collective bargaining law or asking for direction from the city's office of collective bargaining. So I'm just curious why you decided to amend the administrative code.
I think that was a legislative decision made by bill drafting, but I could definitely look into the...
I'm going to support the bill. I'm just curious as to how you wound up in that venue.
Yeah, I think that we can circle back with drafting on that. That's how we kind of took the bill when we proposed the idea. We can circle back on that.
Thank you.
Any other discussion?
Diane covered it for me.
Sorry, covered it? Okay.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Seconded. Okay. Motion is made and seconded. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any in the negative? One negative. Any without rec? Okay, the bill is reported to the Finance Committee. Our next bill is S-3854, sponsored by Senator Lanza.
An act to prohibit public employers from diminishing the health insurance benefits and contributions of certain retired public employees.
Senator Lanza, is there anything you'd like to say on the bill?
It's a good bill.
Okay.
Senator Lanza, would that apply to all public retired public employees?
Yes.
Including potential future public retired employees?
I don't think so. We're not civil servants.
But we are public employees.
I don't think it applies to legislators.
Could I offer a friendly amendment?
I accept it.
Okay. Any other discussion? Motion to move the bill?
Motion.
So moved and seconded. Okay. Motion made and seconded.
Can I just clarify?
Yes.
Because I don't want to. We are civil servants, in the best sense of the word, but not as defined under this legislation.
You have a different test. Yeah.
Okay. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any negative? Any without rec? Okay. Our next bill is S-4134, sponsored by Senator Skoukas.
An act to amend the retirement and Social Security law in relation to authorizing retired firefighters to be employed as instructors of fire sciences by a career and technical education center without diminution of his or her retirement benefits.
Okay, is there any discussion on the bill?
Move the bill.
Motion made. Is that seconded?
Seconded.
Seconded. Motion made and seconded. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any negative?
Without rec.
And one without rec. Thank you very much. Our next bill is, that bill is reported to the calendar. Our next bill is S-4153 by Senator Parker.
An act to amend the civil service law in relation to language assistance services by state agencies.
Any discussion on the bill?
I don't have the bill in front of me, but how does he envision the services to be provided? Is it a contract or is it hiring bilingual staff?
So it's requiring the agencies themselves to provide the services and to determine the best way of providing those services, either by using existing employees or by identifying either interpretation or translation services.
I would just suggest that if they're going to utilize existing employees, that creates additional burdens on those staff. As a former caseworker, we always had a difficult problem getting bilingual caseworkers, and we had many attempts to negotiate assignment differentials for bilingual workers. The city was never willing to do so, and what would happen is workers who spoke multiple languages would be assigned to do this translation service. They would not get any credit for the work they did. They were not relieved of the duties of their existing caseload, and they would fall behind. So I would suggest that before the bill gets to the floor, it state clearly how we want the agencies to provide that, whether it be through contract, through specific tasks and standards of workers, so that they don't put the burden on existing staff and then require them to do something that is almost impossible for them to do and they don't get compensated.
Point very well taken, and we'll make sure I
think in reading some of the fine points and the language, it says the Civil Service Commission is tasked with the development and implementation of a comprehensive language assistance plan to establish uniform policies across all state agencies. So that's what the game plan is. The bottom line is that when people come in, and no matter what their languages are, we need to be able to communicate with them, and they're communicating with us in order to make sure that whatever they're going after, whatever questions they have, it should be dealt with. That's the most important thing. But I agree with Diane with respects to, you know, if the burden on an employee and that employee is being negatively impacted as far as production of work or whatever they're doing, all of that must be considered. And that's why a comprehensive plan by civil service is clearly appropriate.
Points very well taken.
I'm concerned about the mandate on our counties. And, you know, some of our rural counties upstate may never, ever need to do that. I'd certainly support the idea of supporting ELL, but I'm just worried about the cost involved here. And it's different New York City. I get it. You know, it's a very different animal than maybe Wyoming County or something like that. So, I might be hiring somebody and then never do anything all day long.
Senator, I'd note that this only applies to state agencies.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Any other discussion on the bill? Motion to move the bill?
Move it.
I second it.
I change it without rec.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Any negative? One without rec.
Without rec.
Two without rec. Okay. The bill is reported to the Finance Committee, and we will take those into consideration. Our last bill is S-4308, sponsored by Senator Gennaris.
Is he here?
We go by Andrew. Keep it honest.
An act to amend the retirement and Social Security law in relation to criminal justice faculty employed by a community college.
Okay. Any discussion on the bill?
I just want to commend you, Chairman. This is a good bill. It's important that we make sure that we continue to have access to former law enforcement employees so that they can use their experience in the classroom. And I know it's become an issue recently in terms of being able to recruit to and retain, so this is a good bill.
Okay. Thank you very much. Any other discussion? Motion to move the bill. Motion made. Is it seconded?
Second.
Seconded. Motion made and seconded. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any negative? Any without rec? Okay. Bill is reported to the calendar. That is the final bill on our agenda. Thank you very much, everyone.
Mr. Chair.
Enjoy the rest of your Tuesday.
Thank you.